H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So let's get started, guys. Is there anyone who is taking the first time this class? Oh, can you please introduce about yourself, please?
Hi, Srinivas. This is Kalpana. I'm first time attending this class. I never been here.
Okay. Hi, Kalpana.
Yeah.
So what are your expectations, Kalpana? Just to know how the people are expecting so that I could manage to meet that.
Actually, I'm non-IT background. I don't know actually anything.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you have experience at least in manual testing something? You have taken any course of manual testing?
Yeah, I'm almost done my QA course with Priya.
Okay, perfect. Okay, Kalpana. Anybody else, guys?
Yeah, hi. This is Avanti. I have around 3 years of experience in manual testing. Currently, I'm working at NCR, and I want to get more knowledge in automation. Like currently, my team, we have Selenium IDE, but we want to grow, we want to cover most of the scenarios in Selenium. So, and that's what I'm trying to attend. And I have an experience in testing API through Postman.
Okay.
But as per the, current requirement, Selenium is most dominating tool. So,
Very good thing. Do you have any QTP experience earlier or anything, or only first time you're attending automation class?
No, I don't. I don't have experience in QTP.
Yeah. Thank you. Anybody else, guys? Any new joinee today? Please introduce yourself.
Hey, Srinivas, this is Gandhi here.
Yeah. Hi, Gandhi.
Yeah, I joined just now. I joined.
Okay. Okay, guys. So this session, I will ensure all your phones will be enabled, so you can stop me at any time. Okay, and you can ask the question. Also, if you are not asking the question or if you are just listening, please go to the mute so that we won't hear any other voices or any other gets disturbed. Okay, so please do that. If you are not talking, please go into the mute. If you want to talk, please enable your mute and ask your question. Okay, and you can stop me anytime while I started the session. It doesn't matter. Okay, and don't bother about the timing also. If it is 5 minutes less or more, it's okay, it's fine. But I want to ensure you guys understand each and every statement what we are going through, and each and every program what we are doing, as well as each and every session what we are doing is followed. Okay, so I want to ensure that. So feel free to stop me at any point and ask your question if you have. Okay, if you if you don't want to ask and if you want to send mail also, that's fine. Okay, but better clarify it so that if anybody else also have the same question, they also get the clarification very easily in the class. Okay, hope you understand that. So for first 10 minutes, I'm sorry for the guys who are already taking the class from past 3-4 days, and there, because as there are a few more new joinees today, I'm just overall quickly go through Selenium course, what we are going to cover here. Then we will jump on to Selenium IDE stuff where we started in last class. Okay, I'm sorry for the guys who are already in the class and they're going to repeat, because I'm going to repeat it again. You may get bored, but bear it for 10 minutes. Okay. So for the new joinees who are just joined today, so I'm just briefly go through the class syllabus what we are going to take. Okay, these are the main parts of the syllabus what we are going to take as part of this course. Okay, and just let me know if you have any questions with respect to the contents. Okay, the first one, what we are going to start is, we are going to talk about automation, why automation is required, what are the benefits of the automation, what is the criteria for automation, when we have to go for automation, when we not to go for automation, all this stuff. Okay, and also different automation tools and all. So probably this part I'll cover today itself. Okay, don't worry. And next we go with the introduction of the Selenium. Okay, so where why Selenium is required, what are the tools it has, okay, and like IDE, WebDriver, grid, what is the purpose, all that stuff, and everything we are going to work. Our primary focus Selenium is on WebDriver, because that is the one which we are going to do. However, we also touch upon IDE as well, as we will be by end of this classes, we will come to know how to run and execute Selenium scripts using Selenium grid as well. Okay, and also we will also doing Selenium as a Java, its programming language. As you guys, everybody know, Selenium can be used with multiple languages, something like Python, Java, Ruby, C sharp, something like that. But we are going to cover Selenium with respect to Java as a programming language, and that is a widely used even in the industry currently. So if you take the average usage, I see 90% of them use Java, except their applications or their development platforms in different language. Generally, people prefer Java because most of the application development is in Java nowadays. Okay. So then we talk about the introduction to Selenium, why we need to go for Selenium and all, then what are the components. Components in the sense, these are the Selenium tools which we have for the automation purpose, like Selenium IDE, WebDriver, grid. Okay, we will also, as I said, WebDriver is the main crux of this course, and which you are going to talk about lot, and which you are going to practice lot in it. Okay, and it's related topics, something like experts, frameworks, everything. Okay, that will be part of the mainly part of the WebDriver course only, though we have given all the other things what we have, but everything, most of them we cover as per part of the WebDriver. And then we go with the Selenium IDE. So how IDE will be used in the Selenium, basically it's a browser add-on which we could record and test, as well as which we could do basics of some automation scripts using the browser. So earlier Selenium IDE comes only with Firefox, but now the with the latest version it has come up for both Firefox and Chrome. This also we are going to talk about in the today's session once we complete this brief introduction. Okay, and then we in further classes comes, then we start onto Selenium Eclipse, especially Selenium WebDriver, where we use Eclipse as your IDE and then Java as the programming language. So in that case, we cover first Java basics. Okay, basics of Java, how we are going to touch. And again, remember guys, and we are not going to talk about advanced Java in this course. We are going to talk about Java, which we would like to use only for Selenium, because Selenium expects you to be expert in core Java, not in advanced Java. And you don't even require advanced Java for the programming in Selenium. Okay, so if you guys expect Java, we will be teaching advanced. No, we're not. So it is going to be only core Java. And we will ensure that every practice, whatever we get, every program will be exercised. Even in the class, I will take a sample program, as well as you'll be given a program for exercise to do at the end of the day. Okay, and everything will be recorded. Don't worry that way. Okay, now when we go to Java, as natural, every language has its data types, classes, variables, all the declaration that we go each and every step, as well as the conditional statements like if, else, switch, all these, as well as the looping statements where we have while, do, while, for loop, all this. So all these are the basics of any programming language. So as part of Java also, we cover all these basics first, because to start us programming in Selenium, we expect Java to be you are proficient in Java. So that way we are going to teach first Java, then we'll slowly from that programming we switch on to Selenium. So we start with simple Java programs, and then we start learning how to implement Java for the Selenium. Okay. And we also talk about arrays. How do we declare the array, store values, reading values like that, and exception handling, error handling. This is kind of a debugging purpose for the code. So when we do code at the enterprise level, what happens? Many people, okay, will be working parallelly. So suppose if we take a team of 10, okay, maybe 6 automation testers may be there in that, and 4 may be manual, whoever it is. So when people are working, we need to ensure that our code is error free, because everybody should also be able to reuse it. So for that, we need to have proper debugging mechanism, exception handling, all that stuff. So for that, and this is also one of the basic programming skills for Java. Okay. And then we talk about the main concepts of Java, which is objective oriented programming, or OOPS, people generally call. Okay. Then we talk about what is class, how to create object, how to create methods, how to create constructors, what are the different types of return types, and also what is final class, abstract class, all that stuff. And so basically, if you see object-oriented concept, as everybody know, there are only 3 main concepts: encapsulation, polymorphism, and inheritance. We are going to cover up all those 3, okay? Because those 3 are required as part of our programming, even for our Selenium also, whether you say automation framework, or whether you say just a plain test case development. So for all that, we need all these OOPS concepts as well. So we are going to talk about this as well, like polymorphism, what is method overriding, what is constructor overriding, as well as how to return objects from a method, and what is call by value, call by reference, how to use all that. Okay. And then another concept of inheritance. This also, which is very much required, because when we have the common shared code between the modules, we use this inheritance as a tool where we can use others' code as well very easily. We don't need to copy their code and put it in your module. When in real-time world, as I told you, how it happens is when multiple people work, we need to ensure everybody in sync. No code will be redundant. That means, suppose if I create a method for login one of my application, okay, any other resource should not have login. If they create their own, then the code becomes redundant, right? So we need to ensure common code goes to the common methods and people can use it. So that we can do. And all this will be discussed along with the training class as well as the example, okay? So don't worry. Then we also talk about the interfaces. So what is interface, when we need to use all that stuff, as well as the encapsulation and abstraction, something like private, protected, default, what is the difference between these access modifiers, when to use these access modifiers, okay, like that. Then what is a package, how to create a package, all that stuff as well, we will be doing. All these are actually, if you think, basic Java programming, okay? Sorry, could you ask the question in the chat? For the freshers, is the right course to choose for career? Obviously, okay. So why I'll tell you a simple example. If you want to start as a Java programmer, okay, and this course may not be sufficient for you, because as you know, to be Java programmer, you need to expert in both core Java as well as the advanced Java. But here, what we are going to talk about is basics of Java. So any fresher can understand easily the basics from here. And we are not going to write Java applications here. We are going to test the applications on web. So you no need to be proficient here to start with Java programming and Selenium. Yes, you can easily learn. Don't worry about that. Okay, any other questions, guys? You can ask on the phone also, okay? Okay, so, and then we also talk about the collections, which is of the very important topic, something like when we have list of values, how do we handle when we have key value pairs, for example. Data generally in our validations, we take data for different sets of scenarios or test cases, right? How do we handle data? Generally, data comes with data name, variable name, and its value, right? So let's say variable name and value as key value pairs. Our data value name is key and the value which we are going to give it is a value. Okay, so how do we handle these kind of scenarios? All that comes with the collections. For example, if you have a validations to be done from a table where you have multiple rows to be checked. Okay, so those scenarios also, it will be part of the collection. So, and then we also talk about miscellaneous things, something like dynamic binding, auto boxing, which website we can use, download Selenium IDE. Okay, don't worry, I will be let you know once I finish this. Okay, so that I will come, because today we starts with IDE only. Even if you have, whoever attended last class, they would have already seen, but yes, I'll be taking that, don't worry. So miscellaneous things like we cover upcasting, downcasting, auto boxing, and string date math classes. These are all actually general classes we use it for, especially automation purpose, very efficiently. I will tell you why. Date is the common phenomenon where we get in test cases. Most of the test cases in any of the application, most of the applications, if you take, date manipulation is the one we have. Okay, either we give the feature data or something else. And then string also, our validation and verification purposes, strings are required. For example, let's say there is a error message which we generate to the user during the runtime. How do we ensure that that message is correct? So with that, what we do in general, we read from Selenium, read the text, and then manipulate with the string, whether it is equal to expected string or not. So like that. And even math classes, when we have our related to any of the formulas where we can do. So these are all the, again, generic Java classes which we are going to use it for the programming. Okay. Then we talk about the Selenium. So once we finish off this basic Java programming, so once you guys are familiar with the basic Java programming, then we switch into WebDriver. Okay, so don't expect any WebDriver programming until we finish Java, because that is required for us. Okay, so how I inject WebDriver also, I don't just go by only with Java or just by Selenium. I will ensure first you are doing the Java basic programs, then we switch to WebDriver one by one. So once you complete few of the programs, then we switch to, once we finish one feature in Java, then we switch to another WebDriver, how to use that feature in WebDriver itself. For example, let's say we talk about while loop today. Okay, so in general while loop, we just first go with the general Java program for using while loop. Once we finish that and then you are comfortable, then we switch to Selenium. How do we use the same while loop in Selenium? So like that. So we go each and every topic by exercise as well as the class introduction as well. Okay. And in WebDriver, then we cover main parts of the WebDriver, something like how to read your XPath, how to create a WebDriver program, how to run and how to give the data, like data-driven testing, all that part. So as part of this, and also we cover XPath extensively, because XPath is the one which you are going to use most of our Selenium programs. And I'll let me tell you, if you're familiar in XPath, you can do wonders. Even interviews also, you can usually get through if you are very familiar in XPath. Okay, and don't worry, I do have XPath like other methods as well as I know, then we can take each and everything. So you can, I will ensure you write XPath like a pro. It is not like just you just go to the browser, use your F12 or whatever development tools you call, and then just select an item and copy. No, we are not going to do that. We are going to do as a professional XPath writing. So we will ensure that you will be knowing it, because that is very part of your for Selenium. This is very much required, because when in my experience, even in my interviews, most of the times what I see is people are, most of them are illiterate and XPath. They just know how to go to the browser, just point the browser inspector to that element, copy and use it. No, that is not the right way, and that is not going to work every time. Okay, so we will ensure you will be writing the XPaths in a professional way. Okay, so don't worry. And then we're working with different elements. So when we are going to work on the web browser, okay, we all know every browser has its HTML elements for the representation. For example, if there is a text box display in HTML, where it is input box. If there is a checkbox to select any option in our HTML terms. It is actually a checkbox, or input type as checkbox, something like that. So all these things will be covered it. Okay. And okay, and we also will be part of the another thing is data and reading data on tables. So in HTML, we also come to know how to read the data and how to store it in some other purpose. For example, sometimes what happens, data from the one test case output may be input to some other test case. In that case, how do we store the data temporarily? Okay, so that also will be part of it. So we will cover as part of this as well. And once we going through all these things, and then we will be talking about the test NG as well. Actually, though here I'm not given here, we'll be talking about the test NG as a framework. It is something like a unit testing software where we can use you can run Java programs using TestNG, okay? So which we are going to use it in olden days, actually, I mean in earlier cases, people used to have JUnit, but now TestNG is better and advanced than JUnit. So we are going to talk about TestNG extensively also. Even all our programs will be testing using TestNG only. That also will be covered it as part of our syllabus, okay? What are the exceptions as well as what are the assertions in TestNG, how we are going to use all that stuff, okay? Then we talk about the data-driven testing, and this is the crux of automation. The purpose of automation is repeat the test cases with the different sets of data, okay? For that, we need to have data-driven testing. So that also will be covered. And then we will also come to know how to debug the scripts. And that is another challenging topic for everyone. So if there are failures in your test cases, how do we debug and how do we fix it, whatever be the issue we get, okay? That also we cover. This is the one generally most of the people takes time, because debugging and identifying the root cause is challenging always, okay? But we will come to know, I will ensure you do a lot of exercises for this as well to ensure you will be debugging in right way. And I will teach you all those techniques, how we can do. Okay, and then handling of multiple windows. These are all part of the automation scenarios which we cover. Something like what happens when you have multiple browsers to be tested in a single scenario. So that also we will talk about, and how to set and run multiple browsers. So Selenium Advantages, you can run same code on multiple browsers. Something like Firefox, Chrome, Safari, Opera, blah blah. Okay, but here we are going to talk about at least two browsers. One is Firefox and another one is Chrome. Okay, not only this, one more thing what we are going to cover is parallel execution with TestGrid, as well as even some kind of parallel execution with TestNG. So all those things will be covered. So then we comes to the TestNG framework as well. So these are all what we have annotations will be covered as part of the TestNG, how TestNG will be used, how to set up TestNG into your machine, and how to use that. Because TestNG is going to be main program for us to run. So we run from this as well. We are not running from Java main class, because if you want to create main class for every test case, it is not possible. Okay, think of a scenario where you have thousands of test cases for a very huge regression suite. Okay, so to have each and every class main class is obsolete. It is not required. Okay, we are going to use TestNG as a running platform. We will also come to know how to run all these stuff. So all these things, when we start, especially when we start Eclipse itself, I will start with how to load to TestNG, how to create all these programs as part of the course. Okay, and then we are going to talk about Grid, which is, as I said, this is the third component in Selenium, and which is very powerful. You can do parallel executions. You can set up multiple browsers. Even you can set up in remote hubs also. So you can set up a remote browser to run, even that is also possible. Okay, and then we talk about the very important concept, automation framework, and it is again one of the thing interviews many people ask you. Okay, this is a common interview questions which are related to the framework. Many people ask you, how do you explain me about your framework? What are the components? Why you need to use framework? Okay, so all these things will be covered, and we will ensure you write your own framework once you finish off all these classes. Okay, so though I will see again, a framework is something like it is incorporating all your best practices in a way which you can program or automate any of the application. Okay, so this also we'll be going to cover. So while taking the session, so I will go with a sample framework, but we will ensure you'll also do your own framework based on your need. Okay, so that also will be part of this course. And then we also cover up with the page object model framework, which is something like, so here there are different types of frameworks what we have: keyword driven, data driven, modular. Now a page object model is something like one of the design patterns in Java. Using that also we will write one framework and we can use. Okay, initial days, no, we are not going to go with the phase object model. We go with the normal Selenium test ng programs, and then once we become proficient in those, then we will go into the frameworks. Okay, then we also talk about Maven or Jenkins, which is something like a continuous integration and code management tools. So those also we'll be talking, at least some basic programs, how do we incorporate, how do we ensure. So what is this continuous integration tool is something like, in real time, in real world, whenever a new build comes, okay, so this Jenkins will ensure that you can schedule your test cases immediately after the build install. Okay, so what happens, suppose let's say there are multiple teams working on multiple geographies. Okay, some testing team may be in Australia, or development team may be in US or India, whatever it is. In that case, what happens, by the time build comes, maybe testers may not be available, but you can automatically ensure that you can schedule the runs whenever the build is installed, and you can send the results. So all that stuff is possible with the continuous integration service, something like Jenkins. Okay, so we are going to talk about that, and we will do sample programs also. Okay, but this one is very little difficult to explain in our classes, because we don't have any continuous integration servers and we don't have any development platform with us to do. Okay, but at least as a sample exercise, we will ensure, we will install that and do simple program to run from it, and we will ensure that you will also be proficient in that. Okay, and again, in real terms, not everybody use, frankly speaking, not everybody use. Yes, few people use, that we can say, because most of the people, how they do use, either the scripts run manually or they will schedule the runs. Okay, so, or they use the Jenkins as well. Okay, so whoever it is, but we will ensure this also will be covered as part of the syllabus. Okay, any questions so far, guys, before I move into the actual class today? And I'm sorry for the people who has patiently sitting, though I'm repeating the same thing from the last class. Yeah, you can unmute please, and you can ask me a question if you have. Anyone, guys?
This is Gandhi here. Right?
Yeah.
So what is the schedule of the course? How long it's going to be continuing?
Okay.
How many days?
So
those kind of
it minimum things, right? Requires 40 plus hours.
Okay.
Okay. So okay. Maybe up to 45, 50 also, but based on the progress. So suppose, see, for me, it's not like I need to finish off 40 hours and leave it to you. No, not that way. I want to ensure everybody follow the class, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody follow the class, and we are following everything. So it may get delayed by two, three sessions. No, fine, it's okay. But minimum will be 40 plus hours.
Okay. So before start the training, actually, do I need to install this Selenium plugin in my system?
No, not now. Actually, what we do, each and every class, okay, once I complete that, then you can go ahead, and that class itself I will tell you how to install all that stuff. Okay, and one more thing is, no need to go and read the things which you are going to take. It doesn't useful for you. Okay, let me take in the class first, then you go and practice that. So next day, next class when you come, okay, if you have any questions, okay, if you have any questions, you can ask me when the proper schedule starts. Okay, there is a chart. Any doubt so far for the freshers? Okay.
And Srinivas, this is Kalpana. We have missed some classes, so are we going to get recording sessions or?
Yeah, if you miss, yes, we are going to get, but if at all required, suppose let's say due to any unknown reasons, many people missed, probably we can cover up in another session only with those people, maybe a half an hour session once we finish our sessions for that day. Okay.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So that's what I'm telling. It is not like I just give 40 hours of my time and you just go and do. No, let us not do like that. If that is the case, we no need to do this. You can go to the videos and do. Right?
Yeah. Actually, I thought of this is demo class, but unfortunately.
No, demo only. We are going to start. We are going to start.
Okay,
we are going to start. What I mean is, because there are, see, problem is because it is very new classes here and every day somebody else is joining, okay? And for them, they should not feel they are alienated, okay? Right? That is the only reason. I just cover up what we have in the previous classes and what I'm going to cover as part of it. And then we cover up for them. Okay. That is the reason I asked for apology for the people who are already sitting, because I repeated it last time also.
Oh, okay. Okay. I thought of you already started the class. Okay. That's
okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Srini, I have one more question now.
Yeah.
You may feel it is a silly question, actually. You know, you said actually the Selenium we can install, the plugin we can install only Chrome and Mozilla Firefox, right? So yeah. If any, you know, the online application is not supporting Chrome or Firefox, it's only support in IE. In that case, we can't automate that application through Selenium?
No, we can. Actually, but not through IDE. As I said, IDE is a basic programming. Frankly speaking, very few people use IDE only for basic scripts. Actual programming is on WebDriver.
Okay.
You'll come to know in the class, because IDE hardly you do simple things. If you see my frameworks here, example, okay, IDE suits this one, keyword driven.
Okay.
I highlighted C. That's a simple frame, a simple thing, okay? You'll come to know, don't worry. What we are going to start is WebDriver, which is the one when actual learning starts, okay? IDE, why actually speaking, IDE we no need to cover, because we are not going to use it much. But still, why I want to cover is, with this, you get the basic knowledge of Selenium, okay? Which I don't want you guys miss it. I can start directly from WebDriver, no. Because Selenium IDE, if I take first few classes, what you will come to know is, at least you see how the reality works in the automation. Then when we switch on to Java and program, okay, you will compare, okay, this is how it was recorded. Is how I did now manually without recording. Then that makes your life easy to understand. That is the only reason I don't want to miss IDE. Okay.
Okay.
Any other questions, guys? Fine. Sushma, there is question. One, from when proper schedule will start? Sushma, actually, it started even today. Okay. Don't worry. It started, so we are going to talk about every topic every day now, okay? Until there are very any new person, probably I will take first 10-15 minutes like this, and then we'll start immediately followed by that class, okay? Any other questions, guys?
And Srinivas, this is Kalpana. Are we going to get any assignments after every class, or how it will?
Yes, I'm going to. Okay. But not every class, wherever required. Krishna, can we use it on Mac as well for Safari? Yes, Mac very well you can use. Okay, so actually what you can do is, I'll let you just do we get to see how live project works in real world? Yes, you can do. But actually, problem is with this, I cannot show you very live projects where some other company is using, right? But we will go with the projects which are on live on the real world. For example, let's say any travel domain site. Okay, I usually take travel domain sites. It is very easy, as well as some other retail sites like Amazon. How to go, all this, all that stuff, okay? But if you are in a working lot, yes, you can easily do because you will be having your application. If you are a fresher, you can again go with any of the free projects available in Google and then download it and use it any way you can do, okay? Okay, so let me show you the basic stuff with the Selenium, what we are going to start here, Selenium HQ. So this is the one if you guys see here, okay, Selenium IDE is the one which we talked. This is a basic record and playback tool, as well as the WebDriver is the one. And forget about this Selenium remote control, which is a very older version of WebDriver. So before WebDriver, Selenium RC is the one. Why I don't want to teach you, there is no point you will be knowing it. It is obsolete now, nobody is using it. That is the reason I don't want to again mess up your mind saying that there was a Selenium RC, okay? Forget about it. So now let us talk about Selenium IDE, okay? And when you see WebDriver, okay, as people are asking drivers and browsers, right? Let's see what we have here. So if you see here, see you can use Chrome, okay? Even firing Firefox, HTML unit driver, Internet Explorer, okay? Phantom Safari driver as well. And with respect to operating system, can we use Mac? No, yes, it doesn't matter because Java allows you to use any platform, right? Same way, Selenium also you can use it on any platform because it just requires Java, okay? So here you see. So these are all the languages we have: C Sharp, Java, JavaScript, Perl, PHP, Python, Ruby. And the browsers we cover here, browsers, okay? So you have Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, Opera, Chrome, okay? So basically, browsers which supports, right, they do require a driver, okay? So many of these drivers are available from almost all the browsers, okay? Because now Selenium is also under a W3C, World Wide Web Consortium. Most of the top famous browsers, everybody coming up with, okay? Even Chrome also, it is coming. I think whoever not using, because Internet Explorer also, everybody know that it is not going to come, the new version. The new version of Internet Explorer is Chrome. Even Chrome also, there is a driver, you can use Chrome also. Okay, like this, you can see Firefox, okay, Internet Explorer, Safari, Opera, Chrome, all these. Okay, Microsoft Edge, not the Chrome. Microsoft Edge also you can do. Edge also come up with a different browser now. Even Microsoft Edge you can do. Okay, but we are predominantly will be talking on Firefox and Chrome. So these are all the two things which we are going to cover as part of our course. Okay, we will ensure those two will do. Okay, now let's go back to the main. So, okay, let us start with IDE. Selenium IDE, as I said, okay, sorry guys, before that, whoever, okay. So, whoever new to automation, okay, so I'm going to take why automation, all that stuff first, okay, in our syllabus also, if we take, that is the first concept, this one, okay, so I'll finish up this and then we will move into Selenium thing, okay, so now hope it is visible to everyone, and guys, if you have any question, please don't ping me in the chat, just you talk, okay, because I'm going to minimize it so that you could see my full screen. Okay. Okay. Let's start with the test automation. What is it? It is basically use of a software control to just execute your test cases and your comparison with your actual outcomes or predictions. What we call in general terms is validations and verifications. Okay. So that is test automation. So using of a software control, the execution of tests, the comparison of actual outcomes to predicted outcomes, which is expected versus actual. In general terms, we call as validations, right? and the setting up of test preconditions using the conditions whatever we have, and also other test controls and test reporting functions. So how do our test cases have to navigate and all that stuff. Okay, commonly test automation frame involves automating a manual process which is already in place that uses a formalized testing process. Okay, so we just do whatever we are repeating manually, we are going to automate it most of the cases. Okay, so that is what test automation is. Now let us talk about why we need automation testing. Okay, so automated software testing, first of all, saves time and money, which is very, very important, because how it will save time and money is simple, two things. Repeated test cases can be easily executed by its own. Okay, you no need to do programming again and again like in manual test cases. For example, let's say manual test cases, I have 100 test cases. If I want to execute these 100 test cases for every build, okay, I need to invest time on every build, right? So let's say it may take me 3 hours of time. So every build you need to invest 3 hours of time to test those test cases. If you have automation, you just going to run it, okay? It will save your time as well as money because you don't require another resource for it, okay? And one more thing is it can do uninterrupted executions also. That means you can just kick off and leave it. You no need to be part of that execution when it is happening, okay? Because your program, your Selenium automation script has the capability to go over the script as per your defined use case or defined test case steps and perform the actions whatever required for your test cases or use cases. So in that case, it saves you a lot of time because you no need to repeat the things. And one more thing is it improves the accuracy. Accuracy in the sense there are chances that we always do human errors while we test. Okay, there may be scenarios where we mistype something or some test cases or some steps we might have missed. There is a possibility when you work with a huge sets of test cases, or some test cases also may miss. So, but this case it is not, because you define your test cases, you code your test cases, you ask you to you schedule your test cases. That way, each test case will run without any issue. And the data also, whatever be the data you are going to use, you are going to give to the test cases will be used. So obviously, it improves the accuracy of your test cases. And the test coverage as well, sure, because with the current scenario, nobody following the waterfall model where you get two months or 1.5 months, whatever be the time to test your application and do testing thoroughly, all that. Now everybody follows agile or a sprint, whatever it is. So now what happens? Your testing time is shrinked between the releases. Okay. So generally take people may have agile in the sense either once in one release in every 2 weeks, or 4 weeks or 6 weeks, something like that based on their need. Okay, when you have a release in 2 weeks, okay, you hardly get 3-4 days or a week for testing, right? So how do you ensure all your test cases, when you have a very huge applications, your regression test cases itself may be somewhere around thousands, okay? Do you think manually it is feasible, okay, to test that many huge number of test cases manually within the time given to you? Very difficult. All right, so what happens? Your test coverage will come down. What you do? Okay, I do have 2000 test cases. I know that I cannot execute. Now what you are going to do? You are going to take the test cases which are high priority in nature. We execute those manually and leave it the rest, right? But with automation, what happens? Whatever you have, you are just going to run. Let's say you have 2000 test cases, even manually automation also, let's say it takes 3 days. Simple, you split your automation scripts into different suites, okay? Execute in different machines parallelly. Obviously, you could cover your 2000 test cases even in a day, right? So then what happens? Your coverage will be more because automation runs on regression test cases. No manual tester need to work on regression test cases. They can concentrate on the new features, whatever comes into the release, right? So it obviously improves your test coverage. Okay, next one is what manual testing cannot. So what manual testing cannot is lengthy scenarios, as we discussed already, too many scenarios in a release, and you don't have the time where you can't cover everything with manual testing. Then automation is the best solution. Then it helps developers, also testers, because how it helps developers is where there are cases when you want to do sanity just immediately after the release, or even you can give your sanity test cases to developers to run their environment before they deliver also. Then what happens? There is a chance of less errors when you do that, because even they will be tested at front, at least the basic scenarios. And whenever build comes through Jenkins or through your manual scheduling of your test cases, immediately you can run your sanity test cases, ensure your environment is testable or not. Okay, what do you mean by, what I mean with testable here is, testable is something like the basic test cases which requires to test on any application. For example, let's say a simple scenario I will tell you. I am actually booking a flight, okay? My basic scenario is first login using a registered user. Assume a scenario that we got a new build now, login itself failing, okay? What is the purpose of going and testing the rest of the applications when your login itself failing, right? So there is no point, right? So that means your application is not testable now because the basic scenario login itself failing, okay? Assume this scenario and you've given this script to developer as well as a manual tester to run immediately after they run, after they install the build. Then what happened? The first phase, it's first step itself, you will say, oh, this script is failed for the login itself. Guys, your build is wrong. Okay, so you could save a lot of time. Otherwise, what happens? You need to manually install your application. You need to manually check each and every step. And then only you will tell, okay, maybe after 2-3 years, build comes, you say, okay, your build is not good, then you are going to give it the back. So it saves a lot of time for the testers as well as the developers. Okay, even in real time, I've seen few developers which they use our automation scripts also when we develop. Okay, why they use is simple. As I said, build validations, this is the best way. Okay, they can run all the basic test cases. Okay, and then they will ensure that their build is proper before they deliver to QA team, and then QA team can take over from there. Okay, and finally, all these steps, what happens? It actually improves the team morale. Okay, so in the sense, okay, even testers feel, okay, we have very good automation. I no need to worry. I just need to concentrate on the new features. So obviously what happens? The performance of the team will be bettered because you have more coverage. You save a lot of time through automation, and your test coverage is more. Even accuracy of results from your test is also very high because automatically each and validation you provided with the test case will be validated along with your test case, right? Any questions so far, guys? Hope it is good for everyone. As I said, please don't post anything in chat, okay? Please speak on your phone microphone so that I can hear. Okay, then let us talk about when to automate. Okay, when we need to go for automation. The tests which are required to run every build, even I think in last class also I covered this. So which are test requires to run every build. If you're running only for once or once in a year or once in 2 years, please not to. Okay, because the time you invest on your script, you have to ensure that it will save a lot of time in future when you run it. For example, I have a test scenario, it takes 10 minutes for me. Okay, and that is the test scenario contains again 15 test cases. Okay, so if I need to automate those, I need to choose whether it is automatable or not. Whether it is a good candidate for automation or not. So how do I choose is, okay, I'm running this 15 test cases and it takes 10 minutes to me every time. I need to repeat it on every build. Let's say there are 30 builds a year. So in that case, you are 30 into 10, 300 minutes. If I automate, I could save that. Okay, but if there is a test case which hardly require 5 minutes and you execute it only once in a year or once in 6 months when there is a change in that particular module, better not to. okay? Because your investment automation should give you some return. If I invest 5 hours on developing a script, if the script is not used even for 2 hours, what is the purpose of invest? No use, right? So we need to choose that way. So whether whatever test scenario I'm going to automate, is it giving me return on my investment? That means your investment here is spending your time in developing automation scripts, okay? So generally, this is very useful for the people who are working in lead and above level, because they are the one which is going to decide whether this should be automatable or not, okay? So this is very, very important before you go for automation. Then multiple data values for the same action. If you have multiple data values, for example, let us take a simple travel domain, okay? I want to do a flight booking. If I want to do booking for 10 different users, do I need a similar test cases in automation? No, automation test case doesn't require a different test case for a different user. You just need to change the data for that particular test case. So this will be very apt when we have this kind, okay? And this is the general scenario what we get in our real-time world also. We'll be testing same scenarios with the different sets of data, okay? For example, here itself booking I say flight, okay? Flight I say some test case you need to carry, you need to select a particular carrier, for example, United Airlines, whatever it is, or you need to choose a particular destination or a different destination. For example, it may be Las Vegas, it may be Los Angeles, something like that, okay? So then we go for it, okay? And then we use identical tests that need to be executed using different browsers, okay? That is another feature of our automation, different browsers. As we already know, Selenium scripts can be executed on different browsers. So when we have same test set of test cases to be executed on different browsers, your time for manual testing always more, because your number of hours taken for one browser into the other browsers you are executing. For example, let's say my particular project expects me to check in 3 browsers, for Chrome, Firefox, Edge, okay, Microsoft Edge, okay? If I have to execute same test cases on all these 3 different browsers, okay? For this, for example, my test case, test scenario, which has 20 test cases, it takes 30 minutes for me. So that means total time you have to invest is 1.5 hours, because each browser you need 30 minutes and you are going to test in 3 browsers, right? So 1.5 hour investment you have to do for every time. So in that case, better go for automation, because you can run for different browsers, you can run for different times also, even the number of times also. Let's say you want to repeat this for sanity testing, regression testing, or end-to-end testing, blah blah. So in that case, what happened, your usability will be more, so you reduce your number of hours with respect to your manual execution, because automation script can take care all those browsers parallelly. Okay, any doubts so far, guys? Please let me know if I'm going fast or if you're unable to understand it at any point, so that I could answer. Because I don't want you guys go with questions out of this class. Okay, if you have any questions, please clarify here. Don't feel that if I ask questions, somebody may be feeling no, not like that. Everybody's understanding is important. It is not for one or two. Okay, it is for everybody. Please ensure that, stop me at any time if you have any questions. Okay, hope so far it is clear. Especially the new guys who are joined. Hope it is clear. Okay. Now let's see when not to automate. Sorry. Yeah, somebody talking? Okay, when not to automate. Now let's see, okay, we have seen when we go for automation. Now let's see when not to automate, okay? Test cases that will be executed once, or I will say rarely as well, okay? Once or rarely, whatever it is, okay? In the sense, what that does mean is, if you are investing 10 hours of time into developing of your this particular test case or test scenario, but you are going to use it only once in a year, or maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, better not to, because your investment is more than your actual benefit. So in that case, better not to. Again, This also very useful for the whoever working currently as leads and above. Okay, this is very, very important. You cannot go and blindly, okay, I have a test case, let us automate. No, that is not the way. You need to figure it out, return on investment always, okay? If you are just blindly going, it is not going to help. It is going to be burden for the people who are going to develop the scripts also, okay? And then any ad hoc or random testing. Ad hoc or random testing is something like you don't have a particular steps of scenario test case to execute, okay? This one is something like when people want to find any bugs into the machine by ad hoc testing. In the sense, there won't be a particular scenario. Okay, I'll tell you a simple example. You try to apply in a retail scenario, I'll tell you. Suppose you return an item, okay? You try to apply discount on return. Would it applicable in real terms? No, because it is a negative scenario, nobody will do, okay? So those type of cases, you no need to automate, okay? So whenever you do any ad hoc or random testing without a proper scenario or without a proper requirement document, no need to do, okay? That you need to remember. And test cases that are infrequently selected for execution, as I said, if you are executing the test cases very rarely, no, not to automate, okay? And the most important one based on the intuition and knowledge of the application. What does mean is here, a tester may know this is not possible through automation considering the complexity of the test case, but still he want to go and give it to automation team, okay? Better not to. Example, I'll tell you a scenario, simple example here. Our web page is having a flex add-on, and that particular scenario use the flex display of our application, something like charts, example, okay? We know that flex is not easily done by automation through Selenium because it is supports web, not the flex, okay? In that case, what we do, there is no point we try to automate on that flex because we know that it is not automatable. Okay, in that case, better not to. So how to decide is, we need to decide, okay, based on our scenario, whether it is possible to automate, we need to check. If not, okay, leave it. Then we execute that test case manually, and that will be part of your manual group, okay? An application which are more error prone, even yesterday I told you, when there is an application is more error prone, better not to. I'll tell you why. There are 10 test cases, all these 10 having 10 different bugs. What is the point? Your test cases, you are going to fail here. So that is why what experts people are, until your application, your testing is standardized, better not to. That means your application need to be stable to start your automation stuff. Okay, if it is stable, yes, you can go ahead and do. If it is error prone, too many errors every day, every build you are getting. And one more thing is, when you keep getting the requirements change, okay, changing the requirements, I think that I need to add, sorry here. Frequent changes in requirements. Okay. Okay, if there are any frequent changes in requirements, for example, this build what we got today, we got new feature, okay? Don't give that immediately to automation. First, ensure that feature is settled and stable, because there are chances that even in next build, they may change something or there may be new bugs. So we need to ensure once that is proper and stable, then only we go for automation. That is also very, very important. Any doubts so far, guys? Okay.
Thanks, Srinivas.
Now,
quick question. So in Selenium WebDriver, suppose I'm running on Windows, and if I want to run on Safari, can we use the simulator?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
We can. I told you, that there are Safari. See, again, if that Safari browser supports Windows OS, what they provided, yes, you can use. If they provided only for Mac OS, you may not. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so generally Safari is for Mac, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so in that case, if it is a Mac OS, we can happily use. Example, I'll tell you, Chrome and Google, this one we can use because it supports all the environments. Even on Mac also, we can use.
Yeah.
Okay, like that. Okay, Safari also, if you have Windows support by the Safari driver, yes, you can use.
Okay, got it. Thanks.
Okay. Any other questions?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Okay. Now let's see the final topic, benefits of automation. So as we discussed already, it is fast, okay, because it covers many scenarios in time. And one more thing is, it is uninterruptible in the sense you no need to be there on the system to check. You just execute and leave it. It automatically takes care of the things, okay? And it is reliable because it is not going to do any manual human errors, which we generally do tend to do, okay? It is very reliable because you are going to automate based on the each and every step of your test case. So obviously it is going to perform only that until your build changed something, there may be error. Anyhow, that will be part of our debugging, okay? Repeatable, as you know, this can use multiple times, multiple places, multiple browsers, multiple environments. Obviously it is repeatable. And then programmable. So what do you mean by programmable here? Suppose if there is a new change added, you can still go ahead and update your change, and you can append whatever be the new features come into. You can change the existing features if there is issue, all that is possible. Then comprehensive, you can build suites for the test that covers every feature of the application because your coverage will be more. That's how it will be comprehensive. And it will be reusable, as you know, it is program and every program can be reused. Okay. Any doubts so far, guys, before I finish off this and move to IDE? Okay. Now let us move on to IDE. So Selenium IDE is basically a web browser add-on, okay? With this, you can do basic record and playback of your scripts, okay? WebDriver add-on, you can do basic record and playback your scripts. Again, remember the actual test cases which you are going to develop up, we are going to use WebDriver only, okay? But this is to give you the basic understanding of why IDE is required, all that stuff, and how automation is there, okay? So if you go this here, just go to click here, okay? See, right now there are two downloads, Chrome and Firefox. So IDE is available only for these two browsers, okay? So what you do, suppose if you have a Chrome or Firefox, whatever be the browser you are in, just go. For example, this one is Firefox, click on here. See, add to Firefox, you will see, okay? For me, that is gone now because it is already there in my mission. Otherwise, what you can do, just click on add to Firefox, then it automatically gets added, then you will see something like this, remove. That means if you are getting this, means Selenium IDE is already installed for your browser, okay? Where do you see? Just if you see here, there will be icon, see here, rightmost, Selenium IDE, this is the one, okay? This is the one. Now let us start how to use this. So every class, generally I am preparing a kind of a doc so that it is easily for you to explain. You can get this doc as well. I will share it. It's required. So it will be keep on appending with the new sessions, whatever we have every day. Okay. So basically, okay, Selenium IDE or integrated development environment is a tool you can use to develop your Selenium test cases. Okay, it is an easy to use Chrome and Firefox extensions and is generally most efficient way to develop your test cases. It is just a basic way of using developing your test cases. Okay, it records user actions and browsers for you. So the main purpose of this is it is just record and playback tool, but your WebDriver is not record and playback tool. Remember, guys, that is the only reason I want to touch upon IDE, okay? Your WebDriver is not record and playback tool. Your WebDriver expects you to program from scratch, but not this tool, okay? And this is actually a little time saver because recording is very easy than you do your own script for every small thing, okay? However, it has few limitations with respect to it because when you have enterprise level applications, and this is not the best suit, okay? This is good for the basic things, but not for the when you have too many things. Now let's see what are the feature. Okay, let me open it here. Just go to your any of the browser. For example, in this case, I will go here. I just opened with Chrome, guys, and then here.
Hello,
this, yeah.
Yeah, could you please repeat one more time regarding about the ID?
Sure. So, okay. IDE is basically a Firefox extension for Chrome and Firefox, okay? What it does is, so for every automation, the basic principle is record and playback. That means whatever be the manual steps you have in your test case, right? It can be recorded and played back. For example, let's say I want to create a flight booking. I can, so initial time what happens, how automation runs is, without even we create our scenario, it cannot run, right? So what we are going to do with IDE, you can manually record whatever be the actions you want to perform. Okay.
Okay.
All these manual steps will be captured by IDE. Okay. And you can rerun with different sets of values, even the same set of values. Okay. That is the main purpose. So it is basically a record and playback tool. Okay.
Okay.
So to add on that, as I showed
like
you,
USP.
Yes. In QTP, you have record and playback, right?
Yes. Yes.
Same way.
Oh, okay.
Just same way. If you are expert in QTP or UFT, it is same way. Just record and playback, which I am going to show you now. Okay. Now I have installed my IDE here, which you could see here. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Whenever it opens IDE, it will show you. So actually, guys, whoever worked on, I don't know whether you already seen previous versions of IDE was different. Okay. And this is a new versions which they recently started, and it is very good comparative with the previous versions. Okay. Now, whenever you open IDE, what it expects you is there are five options: record a new test, whether you want to create a new test, open existing test if you have existing test, and create a new project, or close Selenium IDE. Now, let us go with the record a new test, right? Now, let's say here what I'm going to do is HTTP dot, okay, for example, agoda.com. You just need to give your project. Now, that is the name I given, guys, but this is the actual URL. So this URL I'm going to work now. And sorry, it is expecting you to be HTTP. Yeah, HTTP agoda.com. Okay, start recording. Now what will happen? This particular URL will be opened by IDE in a different browser. Okay. See, it is open, right? Now, if you remember, you just need to see once it starts recording, your record button, it says stop, and your IDE also, it says IDE is recording. Okay. You could see IDE is recording here. See the bottom of the web browser, IDE is recording, and your record button will be in enabled mode. Okay. This is your IDE and this is your browser. Now, let's say I choose any destination. For example, let's say I want to choose a destination, something like Phuket. Okay. I choose this. Forget about the dates. I'm not worried which date I am in. Search. Okay, now you see. So now you see the results, all this happens. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to do another one small thing. I just going to choose my star rating as 5-star only. I want to display only 5-star hotels. See, now that has been done. Okay, only 5-star hotels have come now. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I can go back to my home page. I don't want to be here. I just clicked on here. Now, all these things, okay, whatever you do, see, Selenium is recording. Now, what I'm going to do, I am going to stop it. Okay, now I'm going to give a name. Okay, let's say search hotel. Okay. Okay, so now this is a test case. So let me explain you this IDE, page, how does it looks like is. What we have here is the project name, Okay. And what I have here is test, test suits, executing. So test is a basic test case what we did now. Okay. Test suite is collection of tests. Suppose let's say you want to combine one or more tests into a group. Okay. And you call it as a suite. Okay. In that case, test suite is the one. Okay. That we will see. And then executing is generally what this is whenever this particular test gets executed, this will keep in executing mode. That you no need to worry. These two are the mains which we need to have. Now it is in test because I just had a test. Now what we have here is run all tests. If you have multiple tests, you can run all tests. Then you can run this current test because this is the one which is selected right now. And other one is, this one is run from it to when we are in run mode only, you could see that. Okay, that I will explain later. Then test execution speed. Generally, it is fast. Fast in the sense, whenever this particular object is clicked, immediately it will look for the next object. So like that, it will go. But if you make it little slow, it will wait for the little of synchronization time. Synchronization time is the time it takes to refresh the application and the application state to be ready to take the next action from you. That is synchronization. Okay. So in that case, what happens? If you make it little slow, you could easily see and you could see what is happening. Okay. What are all the other things you have is you can create new project from here. You can open your existing project. You can save the project, this project, whatever it is, and then pass on the exceptions. This we will learn when in the coming classes. Okay, disable breakpoints, and this is your record button, which is where I started. Okay, so when it is in REC, that means yours is not in record mode. If it is in record mode, it will be record button will be in red color, and it says on your browser Selenium is recording. And then what we see is log, whatever be the runs we have logs and the references unknown. If you have any references to be provided, that is it. Okay, now I ran it. What happens if I run this particular scenario? Okay. This is actually, okay, before I move run, let's see what are all these commands. So what Selenium ID show is, this is the URL what you executed, right? This is the URL what you executed. And these are all the commands. If you see, first one is it is open the browser, there is open command, right? And then it clicks on the search box and type the search, which is the Phuket, the value if you see here, Phuket, okay? So like that, these are all the basic Selenium commands which is giving. If you see in automation frameworks terminology, this is keyword-driven testing. This is keyword-driven testing because this is your keyword, click, and your object, which is a target here, and the action what you are going to do. Because click don't have any value, you just have click. If it is type means, type you are going to type the value. So like that. And then mouse overs, run script is something like when your browser gets refreshed, that will be done. So then again, click here, again, click here. Then you have mouse down, mouse up, whatever be the actions you did with your keyboard, mouse, and even on the browser, whatever actions thrown, everything will be recorded, right? So now if you see the command, what is command is? Command is something like your Selenium command, what you are giving to the IDE. So you're telling that okay, execute this command on this target. Okay, on this target, if there is any value, you just keep it. Because for example, click and all or mouse up and all don't have any value. We are not providing any input. We have provided input only here. That is the reason you have see input value here, but not in other cases, because we did not provide any value in other cases. Okay, any doubts so far, guys? Okay, so now
what is Phuket value?
Okay, this is the search I given. I searched for Phuket city for that hotel, right?
Oh, okay.
I searched for Phuket. Okay, that is the reason it is showing the value, because from my keyboard, what I entered is only Phuket. All the rest of the things I did not given from the keyboard. I just selected from the mouse. That is the reason you have all other things, either click or mouse over or mouse up, something like that. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Any other question, guys? Okay, fair. Now, let us go and run. Okay, this is our basic Selenium recorded script. Okay, IDE recorded script. Now, let us run. Simple. You just go here, select this particular test case, go here, okay, and run. See, now it automatically opens the Chrome browser and it navigates to the page wherever I did. Now, see, it is typing the value. It is already typed, okay, and it picks the first value which comes up again, and it, I have not given any date, so dates don't bother, and then it has to click on the search button. Yes, it is clicked on the search button. So observe, guys, I'm not doing anything manually here. I just left my keyboard and mouse there. Okay, now it needs to select the star rating. Now let's see, you could see even here, see all these steps. Okay. Let it run. Even if it's a failure, don't worry. Okay, there is a failure. So why it is search box button, it has waited for 30 seconds, but still it is not there. Okay, because the loading might be slow. What I'm going to do, for me, I don't require any mouse over for this. Okay. So let me run again. I just deleted because mouse over sandal, I don't want. My main actions will be click, type, all those only. Okay. So I don't want that. If I run again, let me close that browser back. So it is executing here. Yes, it is. You can check. So far, fine. Okay. See now. So now I selected the star rating, right? It has to click on the star rating. Yes, it clicked. So generally, if you choose the runtime as fast, you may not see like this. It will do immediately once the object get visible, it immediately go undo. Okay, that is the only difference. Now, even if you see the hotel, it displays is only 5-star. Now it has to go back to the home menu. See, whatever we see is 5-star. Whatever I recorded, including my mouse move, mouse down, or key type, everything is recorded now. Okay. So now see, it is done. See, it is executed. Okay. So if you see, this log will give you each and every step, how does it performed. Okay. In the previous run, we had seen a failure here because that search button was not visible that time. Okay. Now I didn't want that to be my failure because that search button, anyhow, I'm not validating anything. So I just removed that statement by choosing it. Now, in the latest run, if you see, all the steps are okay. See, all the steps, logging, everything is fine. Okay. Because everything was there. So this is how you run your test scripts. Now, let us understand more with respect to this. Okay, now I explain only today for this, and then we continue with this from the next class. Okay, now what is this command is? This command is the one which are telling Selenium do this. And what is target? Target is actually, let us see how the target is picked. I just show you how it will be picked. So for example, which one I'll take? Let me take this edit. Okay, type CSS. So how this is taken is target is something like your HTML elements description. Okay, in general terms, we will be writing XPath for the same. Right now, it has taken the CSS. Okay, now let's see where is the target is. Okay, this is the one, right? What you can do, just go to F12 on your browser, either Firefox or Chrome. What you get is a web dev tools. So here you have a pointer which points to, it is called inspect element. Okay, now select on it and just do it. So now if you see your input, okay, this is the same type. Okay, type is the command which we given on that particular one, whether search box editor is there or not in the CSS. Okay, if you see your CSS, see here, search box editor is there. Okay, so it is taking by the CSS value of it. For example, let's say you don't want to make it CSS editor. You can just give even in area level also, something this also, okay, or data also, whatever it is. Okay, so right like that it is. Now the value is Phuket. If you see, the value we selected is Phuket. So like this. Now let's say what happens if I change my value to something, Bangkok. Will it run? I'll finish off this and wind up. Okay, let us run. Anyhow, I updated it. Okay, save. Okay, let's say you save it, then it will be a extension of side. That means Selenium IDE. So now let us run. I'm going to close even this. So now we need to change that to Bangkok. See, it has selected. So this is what data-driven testing is. You are using same script for different destinations here in this case. Okay. Okay, now fine. Let me see whether I have, okay. My script also executing good, no issues. Now it's selected the 5-star, right? So this is where you would save the tape. So to search different destinations, you no need to use different scripts. You just use single script by just changing the data. So that's how you could save time through automation, okay? Perfect. I think this is it for 2 days. So next session onwards, we'll be continuing only from IDE. I'm not going to again go back to that part anymore because most of them will be registered by that time. Okay. Any doubts so far, guys?
So whenever there is a failure, it will stop executing there only, or it will continue to execute?
It will stop execution there only, but actually we can even give, if there is an exception, we can ignore that. We will take in further classes. Okay.
Okay. And then, so the browser should be in the foreground, or can it start?
No, it automatically brings the foreground.
So can I say, for example, now I started one testing, and then in the meantime, I want to open the IDE and then copy paste the same thing
multiple destinations. No, you should not. When IDE is running, you should not modify any code.
Okay.
When it is running, you should not modify. You can stop. For example, this state, if you see, it is already stopped, right? You do whatever you want. Let's say you want to change the destination to some value. Fine. But when it is running, not. Because when running, what happens is when you change anything else, okay, the description may change. For example, why it failed, you know, first time when I recorded, okay, I kept a mouse over on one object where it was not displayed for the next time, because that may be a dynamic one which comes. Right, that is the reason I removed that mouse over, then it is working, because that object now I'm not expecting anyhow, because it is not useful for me. Okay, why it is like that is Selenium IDE default, it will captures every mouse movement as well as your keyword. That is how it is captured, but we can ignore whatever we don't want. Okay, let's say we want to just type the data, click on the search, and then search validate the results. In that case, why you want other fields where I kept the mouse and all, right? So you don't require. So that you need to choose based on our purpose. Any doubts, guys?
So also, what are the commands on the left side, right? It shows open, click, type.
Yeah.
So we have to go through any document or something and learn all those commands. What are the commands?
Yes. Actually, no need to learn everything, but most of the basic commands is I'm going to take. And if you want, anyhow, it will be part of my document, what I'm going to have for every session, right? I can share with you guys.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, because every session, see, what I'm currently doing is I do something like this document, okay? Even this one, if you see Selenium also, I covered most of the things, okay? See, again, this it is not a rocket science where I get my own, but I also, wherever good information is available, I usually store it, and whenever I have to, convey to you guys, to without forgetting, I just write down here, at least so that I can convey to you whenever it happens, okay?
Hi, Srinivas.
Yeah.
Yeah, can you share that material with us?
Yeah, sure, I can.
Yeah,
but the thing is, actually, Selenium IDE, let me finish that, then I will share for all ones, okay? Half of documents, it doesn't matter. Once I finish off this, and when we start with WebDriver, right, then I will share the IDE, as well as before that, I will ensure you will be given the exercises as well. In that case, your document becomes useful, okay?
Like,
as I told you, I don't want to share full documents early to you, because you will be over excited to see the document and then you lose the interest.
The full document, like which every class covers every day. So if you're giving the material to us, it is very useful for us.
Perfect. No problem.
And one more thing, Srinivas, I just contacted the people. They are telling, like, when I asked for the recorded sessions, they are telling, like, oh, you need to wait for two more weeks. And again, after two more weeks, they are going to repeat everything back. So they'll do the recorded session. Is that true?
Not like that, actually, because the thing is, I was very confused
with them. Like, they were telling a separate thing. Yeah, tell me.
No, I will tell you, because the thing is, people who joined early, fine, but there are people who want to join maybe 2-3 days after, okay?
For them,
what happens is, actually, I can't directly start with WebDriver for them, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that is the reason we initial 1 week or 10 days, we tend to repeat the items.
Mm-hmm.
That is the reason we don't want to give immediately. Okay, because example, I know many of them are there from the old class, previous class. I covered most of them in previous class also. Okay, for them it will be boring, right? So that way, so once we get the full-fledged sessions is going on, then you get everything. Okay, and I don't even need to repeat everything like today. Okay, if you see whoever attended yesterday's class, yes, they have few of the points which I taken already yesterday, but they are forced to listen because there are new guys in the class as well. So initial few days, yes, it will be like this. Don't worry. Once we start with full fledged, then there won't be any problem. Every day, same number of people will be there. Even we can answer questions. And if you want even any help, we can do that. Okay. Suppose let's say you have your own application while you exercise. Or practicing exercises, you have doubt, I can easily help you. Okay?
Sure. And one more thing, what's the schedule of the class? Like, it's like an alternative day or like everyday classes?
Let me find out, because so far, see, I'm available all the weekdays. Okay, that's not a problem. Okay, mm-hmm. Let me find out. And or you can check with those guys also.
See, when I'm calling, like, they're telling sometimes like every day and sometimes like alternate days, like that's like Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Generally, it'll be every day until if anybody have some other sessions clashed or something like that. Okay. So because it is for initial days, it'll be alternative because people still new guys will be joining. Once we start, I think it can be.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
No, how do you prefer, actually? See, you can discuss with those guys and see. For me, it doesn't matter. But only thing is, why generally they go for alternatives also? They give you the time to practice and come for the next session.
Yeah,
then
yeah.
Every day. Okay.
Actually, when I just
that way they will tell you alternative, but it is up to you guys to decide. If you guys want really every day, even I'm available. Okay, if you guys want alternative days where you can use one day for your practical and come with those questions and to the next class, fine.
Yeah, actually, I already discussed with
Sorry?
You were told that only for this week it's an alternative class, and then from next week onwards it's a daily class.
That's correct. Because initial days, right, when people keep joining, we cannot have every day repeat the same things. Especially, I felt sorry for the people who are there in the start. They have repeated 2-3 times already. Okay?
Okay,
any other questions, guys? So, whoever attend today... Yeah, it is 1 hour. See, strictly I don't say 1 hour. It may be 1 hour, 10 minutes, 5 minutes based on the need. Okay, because if you have more doubts, generally it takes more time.
It is like 1.5 hour class.
Yes, because I had to cover the first topic, which is our course syllabus also for the new joinees, right?
Hello, Srinivas.
Yeah.
Hello, Srinivas. I run the application that what you have thought before for this, and I received one runs and zero failure and search hotel. Now I named it as a search hotel, but after this run, what can I do? What is the procedures?
Okay, you could save that for now. Okay.
For now I can save that. I understand that. What is the
why don't you change your values? Whatever be the destination you given, change it and try whether how it is working.
Okay.
So next session onwards, we are purely talking on these only. I'm not going to cover again new syllabus. If any new people, probably I will touch upon maybe first 5-10 minutes, but not like this. Okay.
Okay.
And Srinivas, do we have to download Selenium IDE or it is?
No, I told you, right? It is just go to the Selenium IDE HQ, then click on that, then you would see here. I already shown you, right? Okay. If you're already in the class, probably just see here what you do.
Earlier in the, hello?
Yeah.
Hi. Earlier you told that Selenium IDE is not used much. As only Selenium WebDriver is used, but seeing this, it seems so useful. I mean, like, why?
That's what I'm telling. It is useful, but the thing is, when you go for enterprise level testing, where you have hundreds and thousands of test cases, you find it very basic or not very useful. Fun. Okay. For example, let's say you want to use a for loop, if loop here in this, it's not easy.
Okay.
Okay, but generally that requires for us when we go for enterprise application automation, because you have a lot of scenarios where you need to use a lot of table validations, for loops, if loops, and validations with respect to text of a field, or validations with respect to error messages what you get from our application. So all that is not, see, for you as a basic learner, you may find it is very exciting, but once you go into advanced level, you may feel it is very small one. But it's okay. That, see, my intention to cover is to first make you to understand what is automation, then bring it to your web driver so that it will be easy transition for you, not directly writing the program on the web driver. Okay.
Sure. Thank you.
That is the only aim. It's not like I want to make you IDE perfect, because IDE, nothing is there to make it perfect.
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
Hello, Srinivas.
Yeah.
So what Java program basic I need to download and keep it ready for the next class?
That I will. Your good name, ma'am?
My name is Sumati.
Sumati, okay. I'll let you know, Sumati. See, basically, we used to have advanced Java version. You need to download JDK.
Okay. If you can show me 2 minutes of your time, like, you know, then I can keep it ready.
Sure, next class, because it's already, time is over this class. Probably next class I will show after the class, okay?
Okay, no problem.
Yeah. If you want to try Eclipse with advanced Java, Eclipse you download, Java you can download, even the Selenium WebDriver you could download. But don't worry, everything I'll cover, I will give the document to you how to download all that steps as well. Okay. Even I will take in the class.
Okay.
Yeah. Any other questions?
Could you please show me, do we have to download this one or it is directly we can record this?
Sorry?
Could you please show again this one? Do we have to download or do we have to directly, we can record?
The class?
No, you need to download.
Selenium IDE. I'm talking about Selenium IDE. Sorry.
Yeah. Once you download, you would see icon like this. You see my right top corner of the browser? SE?
Uh-huh.
Are you seeing that?
Yes.
Then open it like this.
Okay.
Now then what happens? You just give your first project name, then your URL, then it asks you to record. Okay.
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 Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions, guys? Okay.
Could you please give me your email address, please? If we have any doubts, we can.
Yeah, sure, sure. I shall share you actually because full-fledged classes starts from just now. Okay, I will share you because there is, I will let you know. Okay.
Okay.
Don't worry. Yeah. Because it's just basic things. I don't want to share everything to you guys. That is the only reason. Any other things, guys? Okay, thanks a lot. See you in next class. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.